So what we have learned in first lecture is we started with category of laws. We understood there are criminal laws, there are civil laws, there are mercantile laws, laws related to business, laws related to goods. And in chartered accountancy course, we are not concerned with criminal law. We are concerned only with mercantile law. In mercantile law, we started with the first act, that is Indian Contract Act 1872. So what we have started in first lecture is Indian Contract Act 1872, and our full-fledged focus was on what is Act. So any student by raising the hand can tell me a one-line answer, what is Act? Anyone? Yes, Vandan. Vandan,
what is passed to Lok Sabha?
Yes.
Then it bill is passed to Lok Sabha. Then it is transferred to Rajya Sabha. Then they accept it.
Yes.
And it will be signed by President. And Act, the bill which is signed by President is known as Act.
Exactly. So we have learned this in short, that a bill which is passed in Lok Sabha, which is passed in Rajya Sabha, which is signed by President, and this bill will now become, and whatever is written in the Act, every citizen of India, any person coming to India will have to follow anything what is written in that particular Act. So we have understood Act. By understanding Act, we have also understood what is Lok Sabha, what is Rajya Sabha, who is President, who is Prime Minister, who are ministers, who are MPs, who are MLAs, who is more powerful, Prime Minister or President. We have understood everything by learning what is Act. Then we started with this. It is Indian, it was English Contract Act, but we passed it in Indian Parliament. That is, this law was passed in Lok Sabha, passed in Rajya Sabha, signed by President. We changed the name of an act from English to Indian. Also, English people passed it in 1872. And I told you, we don't want to take an undue credit. If it is passed by Britishers, we want to tell the world that it was passed by Britishers. So we have kept the date, that is, it is 1872. And the law is regarding contract. And in this lecture, we are going to commence what is contract. So let me ask some of you. You can give me answer in English. You may give me answer in Hindi also. It is absolutely all right if you speak Hindi. Is it all right? So you need to tell me what you understand about contract. I don't want definition and I don't want some technical answers. I want what is your understanding of a contract?
Agreement.
It is agreement. All right. Varish?
Agreement.
It is agreement. All right. Anyone else?
It's understanding between two peoples.
Good. It is understanding between two persons. All right. Anyone else? Anyone facing problem in their audio, you may even type it down in chat. Huh? I'm also readily available in chat. Any other person?
Written or spoken agreement between two persons.
All right. So in agreement, there is one inclusion. That is, it may be written or oral. Anyone?
Rules and regulations.
It is rules and regulations, all right. Anyone else?
It is formal and legal.
All right. Good. It is formal and legal. Excellent answers. All right.
Okay.
Yes, Varish, you need to speak something?
No, you just continue, sir.
Yes, Varish, go on. Then Devanshi.
Offer plus acceptance.
Offer plus acceptance. This is more of technical answer. Means you might have read something. All right, I've got answers from chat. Agreement or promise between two persons. So agreement between two persons. And deal between two parties. Pooja Shah. Yes, good. So I've got n numbers of good answers. What is contract? Let me create interest in the subject by giving you some of the contracts. Then I will be taking an opinion poll. How many of you agree whether it is a good contract? How many of you agree whether it is not a very good contract or a illegal contract or this type of contract cannot be done? So try to concentrate on the examples which I am giving you. Right now, you will not be able to give the perfect legal answer, but I want your opinion. What do you think? Now you will say, sir, we have not entered into contract anytime. Believe me, when you go to a provision store to purchase a milk bag, then also you are entering into contract, whereby there is a contract between you and that provision store wala that you will be giving money, they will be giving you milk bags. So you enter into minimum 5 to 6 contracts every day, but still you don't understand that you are under entering into a contract, but actually you are entering into legal contract. Under which act? Indian Contract Act 1872. Because if there is any dispute, your case will be fought in court of law. Under which law? Indian Contract Act 1872. So not only commerce students, even science students should be taught this law, which is Indian Contract Act 1872. So let me give you some case. See what is the heading which we are learning? Creating interest in subject. So I'm trying this. I have done one FDP from IIM, whereby we are taught, if you want to really teach to students, you just need to create their interest in the subject. So here is my try of creating interest in this particular subject, which is Indian Contract Act. Let me take case one. There are two people, Mr. X, Miss Y. There is no force involved. So neither Mr. X is doing any force to Miss Y, nor Miss Y is doing any force to Mr. X. They enter into contract that Mr. X will be giving 1 crore rupees to Miss Y, and Miss Y, see, there is agreement between two persons, there is understanding between two persons, there is rules and regulations between two persons, whatever you have defined as a contract. Miss Y promises she will not marry anyone except Mr. X. So if Miss Y will marry, she will marry Mr. X. Otherwise, she will not marry anyone. This is the promise Miss Y is giving by taking this 1 crore rupees. You need to tell me whether this contract is good or not good. Not good means, can you enter into this type of contract or you cannot enter into this type of contract. All right. Let me now remove the layman's word. What is meaning of good in law? Good basically means the contract is valid contract. So, sir, this type of contract can be entered. Not good basically means this contract is void contract. What does it mean? This type of contract cannot be done. This type of contract is absolutely void. That is not good contract. Let me take an opinion. I will be also asking a reason to some person who are willing to give the answer. How many of you think this type of contract is valid contract? Let me clarify once again. There is no force involved. No one is forcing anyone. She wants 1 crore rupees. He wants to give 1 crore rupees. How many of you feel this is a valid contract? You need to raise your hand fast.
Me.
Yes, you just need to raise your hand. All right. Just put down your hands. So there are probably 7 to 8 peoples. 7 to 8 people from 40. All right. How many of you feel this is a void contract? This type of contract cannot be entered into. All right. So majority is on void side. Let me go to valid side. The people who think the contract is a valid contract, can anyone tell me why? Why do you think it is a valid contract? Anyone can speak.
Because there is no force involved in it.
There is no force involved, and there is nothing wrong in giving 1 crore rupees if you are having it. All right. Any other person? Varish?
Both persons are agreeing. This is not a valid contract because it is not a commercial agreement.
All right. And another student who was speaking was saying that any other student having their opinion? Varish is saying that there is nothing commerce about it. Is it all right? Yes, Janki?
Because they both agree with the contract.
All right. So, Varish has given a different opinion that it is a void contract because it is not a commercial. But other all people have given the reason that number one, there is nothing wrong in it. Both are having free consent, means both are telling it freely. There is no force involved. If there is no force involved, there is nothing wrong. There is nothing wrong in giving promise and taking 1 crore rupees. There was one answer from other side also, that is wide side also, that sir, it is not a commercial contract. All right. Any other answers from void side? Those who think that this type of contract cannot be entered into. Any other student?
If it is not in written form.
All right, it is not in written form. All right, so it is not written. All right. All right, void person, some more volunteers. All right, there is nothing much in void. All right, I've got one answer in chat because law has nothing to do with it. It is their personal agreement. All right. But understand, all agreement in a country will be personal agreement. See, you go to a provision store and purchase milk bag is your personal agreement. There is nothing commercial about it, or there is nothing legal about it. You are doing it for your personal sake. When someone is doing business, they are doing business also for their personal sake. That is profit. So you need to understand that there is nothing like personal and professional. The contract entered into between two persons are valid. Sir, we still don't have an answer whether this is valid or this is void. Believe me, I am not going to give you answer even right now. But after completion of Indian Contract Act 1872, after 11-12 days, it will take 12 days to complete Indian Contract Act. You will be able to give the answer along with the law, along with the section. Sir, this is a section whereby this contract is void or this contract is valid. And we will come back once again over here. And you will feel that, okay, you have learned something practically, not only for examination, but practically also. Now we know that this type of contract can be entered into, this type of contract cannot be entered into. Right now, you can give your opinion, you can bluff, but you cannot give an exact answer whether this type of contract is valid or not valid. Just for your curiosity, believe me, this is a correct answer. But still you will not understand why. When you will be understanding? When we will be completing Indian Contract Act 1872. Case number 2. Again, to create your interest, we will be not going into much detail, but still we will be just knowing the agreement. There are two persons. Let me take names from your class. Arjav and Akshat. Arjav is running a provision store. He is having a provision store. See, this is the building in which he is having a provision store. Over here, a big provision AC mall. Akshat is owner of this particular office. There is another office in neighbor. Arjav gives 50 lakhs rupees to Akshat. What Akshat promises, try to concentrate. Arjav is not purchasing this office. This office are A, B and C. Where is Arjav's office? Arjav's office is in B. Who is owner of C office? C office owner is, or shop is, Akshat. Akshat will not be selling this office in 50 lakhs. This office is worth, say, 10 crores. It does not look like, because I have drawn it. But this office is of 10 crores. But Akshat is receiving 50 lakhs rupees, and see what Akshat promises. Akshat promises that he will not open provision store in this shop. Which shop? This shop. There is no force involved again. No one is forcing anyone. Can anyone tell me, just explain me, why Arjav is ready to give 50 lakhs rupees for such a promise that he will not open a provision store in this particular shop? Why he is ready to give? Is a foolish businessman, or there is something logical about it? Anyone? Yes, Krutikaba will be giving the answer. Yes?
There will be monopoly.
Exactly. Arjav does not want competition. To reduce that competition, see, if he might be having turnover of 10 crore, 15 crore rupees. If there is a provision store exact in neighbor, his 15 crore turnover might be reduced to 7 crore turnover or 10 crore turnover. He don't want to reduce his turnover and hence wants to reduce his profit. And so he want no competition, and for that he is ready to pay 50 lakhs rupees. Of course, it will be a profitable business for him, then only he will be ready to give 50 lakhs rupees for such deal. Let us now go to opinion. We'll not be discussing anything but our opinion. How many of you think this is a valid contract? You just need to raise your hand, then I'll be just counting it. This type of contract can be entered into. Again, there is no force involved. All right, it is probably 50% of class. How many of you feel, just put down your hands, please, fast. How many of you feel it is a void contract or this type of contract cannot be entered into? All right. So here there are 30% of them, here there are probably 45% of them. Many of think it is a valid contract. But again, understand, when you will be completing Indian Contract Act, believe me, you will be able to give, I will not be giving you answer, you will be able to give me answer why, under which section, when we have learned this, everything, whether this type of contract can be entered, cannot be entered. See, right now, even if your answer is correct, you might not be knowing the reason. You might not be able to justify it why your answer is correct. The correct answer again is a void contract. This type of contract cannot be entered into. Yes, we will wait up till completion of Indian Contract Act. Come to this case to again discuss it. Third, case 3. It is regarding me and my wife. Out of natural love and affection, I have promised my wife to give her a gold chain of rupees 5 lakhs out of natural love and affection. So again, there is no force involved. And this type of thing, I have given it in writing. What my wife will be giving me is nothing. So we will be learning from raise hand. I'll be just asking one or two people why they think it is valid or void. How many of you think this type of contract can be entered into, valid contract? All right, not many of you. How many of you feel it is a void contract? All right, many of you, because sir is giving more of void and less of valid. Yes, Krutika, can you tell me why it is valid?
Because it is in written form.
All right, so anything in writing you think is valid. All right, anyone with void having a reason, fast. Yes, Varish.
This is a domestic agreement.
All right. Again, it is not a commercial agreement. All right. It's the same answer of void. Why it is a commercial? It is a commercial agreement. Again, I'll not be giving the answer right now. Even if I'm giving the answer that it is a valid contract, believe me, you are not knowing the reason. Last time I'm telling you, once we complete Indian Contract Act 1872, we will be coming back to this case. We will be coming back to all these three cases. And I will be asking you whether it is valid or void. You will be giving valid answer. But at that time, you will be having a provision of law in your words. And you will be telling, sir, this is a reason why this type of contract are valid contract. So this was just to create interest in the subject. You just need a curiosity that, sir, we are entering into this type of contract, whether this type of contract can be entered or cannot be entered. I have intentionally taken such an example where there will be both opinions. Some of you might be thinking it is valid. Some of you might be thinking it is void. If I take some example, like I'll give you 1 crore rupees and you kill Mr. X, then such will be void. All of you are knowing it. But I have intentionally taken such an example where the coin will be falling on any of the side. So let us now go to actual academics. This was just creating curiosity in the subject or interest in the subject. Let us actually go to our Act, Indian Contract Act 1870, and we are going to learn first point, what is contract. What is Yes, I have taken your opinion. You have, some of you have given excellent answer. Probably all of you have given excellent answer. But we will be now learning technically what is written in this particular act. What is the definition of contract? So let's start with contract. Under section 2H. Section 2H. Now, sir, what is a section? I'll tell you why sections are made. The reason is same why your page numbers are made. See, if you are having same book, say this book, and if I tell you open page number 25, and this is written, see, you are standing in court of law, you are a lawyer, you are telling to judge, in page number 25 of this book it is written. Now the judge might not be having that particular book. Then what judge will do? The judge will order your book, or judge will ask that give me your book, and this will happen in court of law. All right. But what the law has intentionally done, they have written section. Say, what does section 2H defines? It defines what is contract. It defines what is contract. So whenever a lawyer says to judge, under section 2H it is written, so judge will be opening his page number, lawyer will be opening his page number, but both will be under which section? Under section 2H. So in page number there is a problem. What is the problem? All of you need to have the same book. But if you give section number to particular thing, then you might not have the same book, but the section will be saying the same thing. So why sections are written? Sections are written for reference, so that judge, lawyers, people like you and me, teachers, students can easily give a reference that, okay, it is written under which section? Under section 2H. Sir, do we need to remember this section? The answer is legally no. Your foundation book, your foundation syllabus says that it is not necessary for foundation student to remember the sections. But in my class, believe me, you will be remembering all the section in classroom itself. You just need to take pain of 5 minutes, 10 minutes at your home, and the sections will be remembered. Also, mercantile law is a descriptive subject, so you need to write down the answers. If you write down the section number, it will create a different impression in the mind of paper checker. So once we complete it, we'll be noting down all the sections, and it will be helpful to you, and you can just understand and mug up the sections, but it will be automatically understood. What is section 2H? It is defining contract. It says agreement enforceable by law. Agreement which is enforceable by law is contract. So let us understand one by one. Agreement enforceable by law is a contract. So we are first understanding what is the meaning of agreement, sorry, what is the meaning of enforceable by law? Only this portion. Try to concentrate. I am giving you two examples where one example is enforceable by law, another example is not enforceable by law. There are two persons, Mr. Daud Ibrahim, Mr. X. Mr. X gives 5 crore rupees to Daud Ibrahim, where Daud Ibrahim promise that he will kill Mr. Narendra Modi. Narendra Modi is Prime Minister of India. Now he might be having his personal benefit, business benefit, political benefit, we don't know. So only I have not taken name. Don't tell this example to anyone, the BJP people will kill me. But the thing is, this is a contract. Now, Mr. X has given 5 crore rupees to Daud Ibrahim. Mr. Daud Ibrahim is not killing Narendra Modi. And now he is refusing that I will not kill Narendra Modi. Has he taken 5 crore rupees? The answer is yes. Can Mr. X go into court of law and argue that I have given 5 crore rupees to Daud Ibrahim and now Daud Ibrahim needs to kill Narendra Modi or he needs to give me 5 crore rupees back? Can he go into court of law? And believe me, unanimous answer will be no. All of you will be saying no, that he cannot go into court of law and enforce such a contract. So this contract or this agreement is not enforceable by law. You cannot go into court of law taking this agreement. That tell Daud Ibrahim to kill Narendra Modi or give me my 5 crore rupees back which I have given him to kill Narendra Modi. This contract is not enforceable by law. Will it become a contract? Never. Why? Agreement which is enforceable by law is a contract. I'll tell you the contract which is enforceable by law. Let me take two examples. Ayush. And Jagdesh. Ayush promises that he will be giving car to Jagdesh and Jagdesh will be giving rupees 4 lakh rupees to Ayush. Ayush has given car to Jagdesh. But Jagdish is not paying 4 lakh rupees. He has taken the car. He has taken the keys. He is even driving the car. So Jagdish is enjoying the car. But he is not paying 4 lakh rupees. Can Ayush go into court of law? My question is whether he will be winning or not. No. My question is, can he go into court of law for fighting the case, for complaining? The answer is yes. Then this agreement is enforceable by law. See, this contract or this agreement was not enforceable by law. This agreement is enforceable by law. For becoming a contract, it should be enforceable or it should not be enforceable. It should be enforceable by law. So this will never become a contract. This may become a contract if it satisfies the definition of agreement, because what we have learned up till now is enforceable by law. So let me write down this point again. 2H, agreement enforceable by law is contract. What we have absolutely understood, what is the meaning of enforceable by law? What is meaning of agreement? This portion is pending. What is meaning of agreement? Let us understand meaning of agreement. Now, agreement is defined under section 2E. What is agreement? So, your meaning will not be done. Whatever you think will not be done. Whatever is written in the law will be done. What is contract? Agreement enforceable by law. We have understood the meaning of enforceable by law. Now we are understanding meaning of agreement. What is agreement? Agreement is promise having consideration for each other. What is agreement? Promise having consideration for each other. Forget about what is promise. Let us concentrate right now over here. Having consideration for each other. Try to concentrate. Again, I'll be taking two examples where there is consideration for each other and another example which is not having consideration for each other. Same example that I have taken, Ayush and Jagdesh. Ayush will be giving car to Jagdesh. Jagdesh will be giving 4 lakh rupees to Ayush. What Jagdesh is getting in this contract? Can Jagdesh tell me? Jagdesh, can you come online?
Yes, sir.
Yes, what you will be getting in the contract? What is your benefit? What you are getting in the contract?
Car.
Car? So, understand Jagdesh, your consideration is car. Ayush, can you come online?
Yes, sir.
What is your, what you are getting in the contract? Getting money. Yes?
Money. 4 lakh.
Money. Rupees. 4 lakh rupees. So, 4 lakh rupees will be consideration for Ayush. So, understand, both are having consideration, both are having some benefits, and so this contract is having consideration for each other. See, this just means the consideration should be on both sides, and so there is consideration for each other. Let me take another example where there is no consideration for each other. I and my wife. I will be giving gold chain to my wife. What my wife is giving me? Nothing. Then, here there is no consideration for each other. What does it mean? Consideration is not on both the sides. My wife is getting gold chain, but what I am getting? I am getting nothing. So there is no consideration for each other. So when there is no consideration for each other, it cannot become agreement. And understand, anything which is not an agreement will never become contract. Why? Agreement enforceable by law is contract. So, there should be agreement. And what is agreement? Promise having consideration for each other is agreement. And what is, what we have understood, not the meaning of promise. We have understood having consideration for each other. What does this portion mean? Having consideration for each other. So, try to concentrate once again. 2H says agreement enforceable by law is contract. We have understood this separately, and we have also understood this under section E. What we have understood about agreement, it is a promise having consideration. For each other. What we have understood already? Having consideration for each other. Now what we'll be understanding is the promise. Now see, at the end of the lecture, you can tell to your parents, to your friends, what you have understood today is meaning of promise. But believe me, if someone tells you to define what is promise, it is very difficult to define promise. Can anyone try? What is promise? In the class of 35-40, no one is able to define. You may speak it in Hindi also if you want. Vandan?
What we say we will do is known as promise.
Alright, what we'll say we will do is a promise. Alright, so Vandan has tried to define. But let us understand from right now, I will be asking you your opinion. But whenever now someone asks you what is promise, and if it is defined under the act, you will have to give that definition to promise. Promise is defined. So what is agreement is defined under section 2E. Let me write down it a proper place. It's 2E. And what is promise is defined under 2B. What is promise? Offer when accepted becomes promise. So the definition is different from what Vandan says. Try to concentrate what I am asking. Will you join my foundation class at a rate of 35,000? This is my offer. You say me yes. This is your acceptance. This is your acceptance. Now it has become promise. Now it has become promise because there was an offer, there was an acceptance. It should be both offer plus acceptance will become a promise, which we want for agreement. An agreement we want for contract. So what is promise? Offer when accepted. See, I am telling you, you join my classes tomorrow at the rate of 20,000. This is not an offer. This is an order. See, if your class teacher or if your teacher at your school asks you, will you go out of the class? This is an offer. If your teacher says, go out of your class, this is not an offer. It is an order given by your teacher. So there should be offer. And there should be acceptance. If there is offer plus acceptance, it will become promise. So this is how law is made. This is how the definition is made. What we are trying to understand, what is contract? What is contract? Agreement enforceable by law. What is agreement? Promise having consideration for each other. What is promise? Offer when accepted becomes a promise. So this is how, if someone asks you in detail what is contract, tell them this. Under section 2B, let me not write down the section once again. Offer plus acceptance will become promise. Promise having consideration for each other Promise having consideration for each other will become agreement. Agreement which is enforceable by law will become. Of course, you cannot write down in this manner, a mathematics way, you cannot write down law. But this is good for understanding. If someone asks me now what is contract, I'll give a straightforward answer. Offer when accepted becomes a promise. promise having consideration for each other will become a agreement. Agreement enforceable by law will become a contract. And we have understood meaning of each and every word in all these three statement. Offer when accepted becomes a promise. Promise having consideration for each other will become an agreement. Agreement enforceable by law will become a contract. We also know the section number of all the cases. Is that all right? All right. I will be taking some cases whereby I'll ask you whether it is a promise or not. Whether it is an agreement or not. Or whether it is a contract or not. All right. First, case one. Your class teacher tells you, go out of the class. And one student will participate and tell me whether it is a promise or not, whether it is agreement or not, whether it is contract or not. I'll give chance to one student to raise the hand first. Yes, Krutikava.
It is not an offer, so it will not become promise and so on, not an agreement and not contract.
Very good. See the answer. It is not an offer. If something is not an offer, offer plus acceptance becomes a promise, so it will not become a promise. And once it is not a promise, it will not become agreement. And once it is not an agreement, it will not become a contract. Absolutely correct. Because offer plus acceptance is promise, and promise having consideration for each other is agreement. And agreement enforceable by law is a contract. So it is neither promise nor agreement nor contract. All right. Second, somewhat typical, and I'll still need one volunteer, but you need to understand what is the case. Case number two is, your class teacher says, will you go out of the class? And you say yes. I want one volunteer to give the answer. Whether it is promise or not. Tisha.
Yes, sir. It's a promise.
It is a promise. All right. Then, agreement or not?
Yes, sir. As it's promise, it's agreement. It's agreement too.
How? What is an agreement? Promise having consideration for each other. Can you tell me, Tisha, what is benefit for a teacher?
Student won't disturb that.
All right. And what is the benefit for student?
By going outside, he can do anything he wants.
See, I absolutely agree with Tisha. If you can give this two answer, whatever the answer might be, it might look funny, but it is an agreement. Whether it is actual agreement or not, but if you can give justification, understand. When you can give justification, you are going to become a lawyer. You need to prove to court that there is a consideration for each other. The benefit might not be in money only, it might be anything. All right. Say you will be giving me money as a consideration. I will be giving you education as a consideration. So it is not every time money which is a consideration. Tisha has proved that there is consideration for each other. Is it a contract, Tisha?
Yes, sir.
Yes, any agreement. This can be enforced it into court of law even, so it will become a contract. All right. So, will you go out of a class saying yes is becoming a contract. Is it all right? So, I'm taking another in case two. I am asking to my wife, will you purchase necklace of rupees 1 lakh? And she says yes. Yes, anyone who will raise the hand first, I'll ask him or her. Tisha, your hand is raised fresh.
Yes, sir.
Yes, tell me.
Yes, it's a promise.
It is a promise. All right. Can you help me, Tisha? Why?
It's an offer and she said yes.
All right. There is offer as well as acceptance. Yes, whether it is agreement or not.
Yes, sir. It's an agreement.
All right. I am specifically telling you that I am not benefited by this contract. My wife is benefited, of course, no one can doubt, but I am not benefited.
Yes, sir.
Then also it will be agreement? The answer should be no. Try to concentrate. There should be a consideration for each other. What is my wife's consideration? Necklace of 1 lakh rupees. What is my consideration might be happiness, but I am telling you I am not getting any happiness. So I am not having any consideration. So I am proving you that it is not an agreement. All right. Trisha, can you tell me if it is not an agreement, whether it will become contract or not?
No, sir. It won't become a contract.
It would not become a contract. So any question is important. If someone asks you whether it is a promise, the answer is yes. If someone asks you whether it is a contract, the answer is no. All right. Case number 3. What is case number 3? It is between Daud Ibrahim and Mr. X. What we have done already. Mr. X is giving 4 crore rupees. Daud Ibrahim will kill Narendra. Sir, this offer was given, yes, offer was given by Mr. X and it was accepted by Daud Ibrahim. So there was offer and acceptance. I will need one volunteer to give me answer. I specifically told you there is offer and acceptance. Dhruvil.
Yes, sir.
It is a promise or not?
Yes, it is a promise.
All right. Agreement?
Yes, it is agreement because there is consideration for each other.
How? What is consideration for Mr. X?
So he will get 4 crore rupees.
He will have to pay 4 crore rupees. All right. What is consideration of Daud? He will be getting 4 crore rupees. What is the consideration of Mr. X? Narendra Modi being killed. He might be benefited.
He will be more dangerous that he has killed Narendra Modi.
All right. Also, if he is not having benefit, he will not be giving 4 crore rupees. He might become next prime minister. He might be politically benefited. He might be any other way benefited, but he is having a benefit. So is it an agreement?
Yes.
Yes. Is it a contract?
Yes.
Why? Can this what is contract? Agreement? Enforceable by law. Is this agreement enforceable by law?
No,
this cannot be enforced in court of law. See, if Daud Ibrahim takes 4 crore rupees and he kills Narendra Modi, the contract is over. But our question is, can they go into court of law? The answer is no. If say Daud Ibrahim kills Narendra Modi and if Mr. X is not giving 4 crore rupees, can he go into court of law? The answer is no. Once he cannot go into court of law, it is not enforceable by law. Once again, whether it is contract or not?
No,
it is not a contract. See, again, I am telling you, it depends upon question. Just by seeing the question, don't say no. If someone asks you whether it is a promise, yes. Whether it is agreement, yes. Whether it is contract, the answer is no. Is it all right? Last example. Case number 4. It was between Ayush and Jagdesh. Ayush, Jagdesh. Ayush will be giving car to Jagdesh. There is an offer by Ayush which was accepted by Jagdesh. Jagdesh will be giving 4 lakh rupees to Ayush. There is offer and acceptance. Yes, I want one volunteer. Any student. Vandan.
Yes, sir, it is a promise.
All right.
It's agreement too, because both will be benefited.
Both will be benefited.
Yes, an agreement is enforceable by law, so it's contract also.
Exactly. If any one party refuses, then other party can go into court of law. And so this contract, this agreement will become a contract. Absolutely right. See, you can see full-fledged chart. It depends upon question whether it will be right or wrong. Whether it will be yes or no. If someone asks you this Dawood Ibrahim contract, you will say it is an agreement, but it is not enforceable by law, so it is not a contract. So try to understand, it depends upon a question whether something will be promise or not, something will be agreement or not, or something will be contract or not. But what is our target? To understand what is contract, which is agreement, enforceable by law, will become a contract. A promise having consideration for each other will become an agreement. Offer when accepted will become a promise. So this is a concept of agreement, promise, as well as contract. We are going to next point, which is basic types of contract. Basic types of, say, agreement or there are three basic, there are n types of contract, but there are three basic types of contract. Valid, voidable, and void. Let me first concentrate on valid contract. There are two parties. I have already taken this example, Arav Jagdish. Arav will be giving car to Jagdish. Jagdish will be giving 4 lakhs rupees to Arav. Alright, let me teach you two words of law. Whether you are from English medium or any other medium, it will not make any difference. You might not be knowing these words. Let me first explain you that words. Say this is a contract, Arav and Jagdish. Arav will be giving car to Jagdish. Jagdish will be giving 4 lakh rupees to Arav. Both Arav and Jagdish are parties to contract. So this two party has entered into contract. Arav and Jagdish are parties to contract. Concentrate. If Arav gives a car to Jagdish, but Jagdish does not give 4 lakhs rupees to Arav, who is having problem in the contract, or who is having loss in the contract? Can anyone tell me? Arav has given car to Jagdish. Jagdish has not given 4 lakh rupees to Arav. Who will be having problem in the contract, or who is at loss in the contract? Arav? Yes, I've got answer in chat. He will be Arav. So Arav, in legal language, will be treated as aggrieved party. The party who is at loss, the party who is actually having problem in the contract, the party who will normally go into court of law. Arav is which party? Aggrieved party. So now onwards, the person who is performing the contract, he has given the car, but he is not getting back in return. From now onwards, we will be telling that party as an aggrieved party. Jagdish, on other hand, has is benefited but has not performed his promise. He has defaulted in his promise. So he will be termed as defaulting party. He will be termed as defaulting party. Two names, aggrieved party, defaulting party. Sir, RO will be always aggrieved party? No. See, let me make RO as a defaulting party. Another scenario, if Jagdish has given 4 lakh rupees, but Arav has not given car, then Arav is a defaulting party and Jagdish will be aggrieved party. A quick answer anyone can give. Which party will normally go into court of law? Defaulting or aggrieved?
Aggrieved
party.
Aggrieved party.
Yes, all of you are correct. Aggrieved party will normally go into court of law. There is no reason why defaulting party will go into court of law. Normally, aggrieved party goes into court of law. All right. Let us go to our previous chart, which is valid, where we have taken same example. My question is, if J is aggrieved, can he go into court of law? See, whether he will be winning or losing, that is a different thing. If J is aggrieved, can he go into court of law? Any one volunteer will give me answer. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, Krutika, I'll ask you one more question. When J will be aggrieved?
When he was getting car.
Then he will be aggrieved?
Yes.
When J will be aggrieved?
When he will not get
in. Yes, Prisha, can you give me answer? Prisha, your voice is not audible. All right, I've got answer in chat. When he pays but does not get a car. This is absolutely correct answer. When J will be aggrieved, when he has performed his promise. So he has given 4 lakh rupees, but he has not got this car. So he has not got this car, then J will be aggrieved. When J will be aggrieved, Krutika Bhai has told me that he can go into court of law. If he is aggrieved, can anyone tell me when A will be aggrieved?
Yes.
Yes, Krutika Ba, same. Yes.
When he has given car but not getting money.
When he has given car but not getting money. Yes, then A will be aggrieved. If A is aggrieved, can he go into court of law?
Yes.
The answer is yes. All right. So, in short, we can write down that both the parties can go into court of law. Both will not go simultaneously. But if any party is having problem, whether Arav or Jagdish, they can go into court of law. And so, when both the parties can go into court of law, the contract will become a valid contract. This contract will become a valid contract. Let us first understand other things. And then we'll be going ahead. What is void? What is void? Try to concentrate. I am taking same example so that it becomes easy to elaborate the example also and to understand the example also. There are two person, Daud Ibrahim and Mr. X. Mr. X will be paying 4 crore rupees to Daud Ibrahim. Daud Ibrahim will kill Narendra. My question is, if Mr. X is aggrieved, can he go into court?
No, sir.
First,
no, sir.
Yes, no, no, I've got no answer. Let me write down no. My question is, when Mr. X will be aggrieved?
When Daud will not kill Narendra Modi.
When Daud will not kill Narendra Modi, then Mr. X will be aggrieved. Can he go into court of law? I have got n numbers of answer. The answer is no. Your answer is correct. If Daud is aggrieved, and when Daud will be aggrieved, I will be giving you answer. When he kills Narendra Modi, but he does not get 4 crore rupees, then Daud will be aggrieved. Can he go into court after killing Narendra Modi? Can he go into court of law that I have not got my money? The answer is
no.
So, in this case, whenever you find out a contract, there will be two parties. You need to think, if this party is aggrieved, can he go into court of law? If the answer is no. If this party is aggrieved, can he go into court of law? If the answer is no, then both parties cannot go into court of law. And so this type of agreement will be void agreement. Void are not contracts. I'll teach you what are void contracts. But right now understand they are void agreements. But they are void because both party cannot go into court of law if they are individually aggrieved. Let us go to voidable. Now, if you have understood permutation and combination, here there is right, right, wrong, wrong. So in voidable, there will be this. If one party is aggrieved, he may go into court of law. If another party is aggrieved, he cannot go into court of law. And believe me, the example is extremely difficult because you will not find out any contract where one party, if aggrieved, can go into court of law. Another party, if aggrieved, cannot go into court of law. Let me give you an example. This is I. This is Mr. Daud. I have given my house to Mr. Daud. And Daud has paid me rupee 1. Daud has paid me rupee 1. Why I have sold my house at rupee 1? Because he has showed me a gun. So of course Daud Ibrahim comes to my home and tells me by showing a gun, that will you sell your house at the rate of rupee 1? I will always say yes. I have given him my house. He has given me rupee 1. The question is, if I is aggrieved, he is. Why? Even if he gets rupees 1, he is having loss in the contract. This contract was entered into by force. So he will be normally aggrieved. Yes. Can he go into court? The answer is yes. Alright. If Daud is aggrieved, you will say, sir, Daud can never become aggrieved. I am telling, if Daud becomes aggrieved, I will also give you a scenario where Daud is aggrieved. If Daud is aggrieved, then he cannot go into court of law. I'll give you an hypothetical example in this scenario, but in practical scenario, there are n numbers of points which can happen. If Daud becomes aggrieved, say this is a ghost house. Bhoot rehta hai is ghar mein. And in this ghost house, the ghost is after a person who is owner of the house. So before, ghost was behind me. Now ghost is behind Daud. And now Daud feels that I want to return this house to Mr. I. And now he again comes to me with a gun. Now I refuses that even if you shoot me, I will not take ownership of this house because there is a ghost behind me. This is an hypothetical example. There can be a real example also, but right now concentrate on this hypothetical example. My point is, if Daud is aggrieved, can he go to court? The answer is no. So, if one party aggrieved, he can go into court of law. If one party, Daud, aggrieved, he cannot go into court of law. And so, this type of agreement are voidable agreements. They are voidable contract. The name is contract. They are voidable contract. So, try to understand this particular chart. What is this chart saying? If both parties can go into court of law, it is valid. If both side it is right, it is valid. If one side it is right, one side it is wrong. If one party agreed, he can go into court of law. If another party agreed, he cannot go into court of law. This type of contracts are voidable contracts. And one party cannot go into court of law, another party also cannot go into court of law, they are void agreement. So, at the end of the lecture, at the end of Indian Contract Act 1872, I will give you a situation, I will give you an agreement, you just need to tell me whether it is valid contract or voidable contract. And if you are able to tell me the answer whether it is void, voidable or valid, believe me, you will be absolutely clear with Indian Contract Act 1872. But you should be absolutely clear with what is valid, what is voidable and what is void. Once again, valid, both parties can go into court of law. Voidable, one party can go into court of law, another party cannot go into court of law. Void, both parties cannot go into court of law. Stop. Now onwards, we will not be speaking this word. Can go to court. This is not good legal statement. What should be written? Can enforce into court. Agreement enforceable by law. Can enforce into court. This is the same thing. Just this is a layman's language, normal person's language. This is lawyer's language or law language. Can enforce into court or not. So once again, if both party can enforce the contract into court of law, it is valid. If both party cannot enforce the contract into court of law, it is void. If one party can enforce and another party cannot enforce into court of law, it is voidable contract. These are three basic types of contract which we have understood.